What can one catch that was never thrown? Cold? Trick question. But simple answer, right? Our common sense sometimes misses to function as desired. I'll talk more on this, but first let's listen to a childhood story and see how it is related. Welcome to Mixer and Grinder. Let me quickly tell you the story of the monkey and the crocodile. Long ago, a monkey lived on a jamun tree located near a river, in which lived a crocodile. The monkey offered the sweet jamun fruit to the crocodile. They became friends. On eating the fruit, the crocodile's wife said that she wanted to eat the monkey's heart as it must be very sweet. The crocodile was shocked, but she wept, saying she would die if he did not listen to her. So, the crocodile invited the monkey to dinner. On the way, he told him that his wife was sick and had to eat a monkey's heart. At once, the monkey understood the truth. He said, "Oh, I've left my heart on the tree." They went back to the tree. On reaching the tree, the monkey quickly climbed up, saying, "You're not only unfaithful, but also a fool. How can anyone take out their heart and continue to live?" Moral of the story is, always use intelligence to overcome a difficulty. They say that common sense is no more common. We try to believe that it's not true, but then we meet certain people and we start to believe that it's a fact. We meet them again and it guarantees that it's like a deodorant. People who need it the most never use it. I don't want to inflate the whole COVID-19 or the mask situation here right now. But I remember visiting the swimming pool of a famous hotel where I read a board that said, "Do not breathe underwater." Just imagine what all kind of people they had to deal with in order to put up such a board up there. Now, there's a whole list of things that people do to demonstrate lack of common sense that we all know, like littering at a public place, not maintaining queue, being loud and annoying in restaurants, etc. To join the list, we have some next generation items too. For example, swiping right when someone hands over their phone to show you a picture, checking your phone in the middle of a face-to-face conversation with someone, peeping into someone else's phone, or if I have to give few examples from the corporate world, then sending a meeting invite without checking everyone's calendar, cutting off people in conference call when they're speaking, eating stinky food in the break room, etc. I'm sure you all would certainly relate to it. In this story, the crocodile lacked common sense for sure, but he lacked emotional intelligence too. He succumbed to his wife's emotional drama and ended up losing a good friend. Ultimately, we all are social animals and tend to get swayed by other people's emotions. Happens with almost all of us, right? But if we become more self-aware, practice social awareness, and improve self-management, we can definitely get better at it. Trust me. Also, we sometimes experience a nervous breakdown when we suddenly fall into a difficult situation. Imagine yourself stuck in a difficult situation, like, say, if you're walking alone on a road late at night, like any other day, and we suddenly feel like we are being followed or chased. We panic and may not be able to think straight. But at the back of your mind, we know that it's a common sense to ask for help. Maybe call and gather people, or even call the police in a worst case scenario. Though so common, but it skips our mind in such dreaded moments. Sometimes we care too much about what people would think of us if it turns out to be a false alarm. We resist to change. We avoid breaking away from our regular regime and silently pray that nothing bad happens to us. We ignore the situation by not taking any action. What if it ends up on a dangerous note? So, keeping aside all the thoughts, a little bit of intelligence would always come handy. The point I'm trying to make is, since Stone Age, our mere survival depends on how effectively we use our intelligence to react to difficult situations. And even Einstein has quoted that the measure of intelligence is the ability to change. Check out more videos that will come here, and you can subscribe to channel here. Don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with someone you think might enjoy it too. If you have already subscribed, click on the bell icon for notification on new videos from me. Let me know in the comment section if you want me to pick any of your favorite story and make a video on it. Until then, bye bye.